looking, isn't it? Well, nearly half a decade after BMW launched the first generation X4, comes the second generation model. What's even better is that this car is on sale in India and has been fairly quick to make a name for itself. Hello friends, I'm your host Atharth, and right now you've tuned into the video channel of indianauto.com. Before I proceed with my review, I request you all to hit the subscribe button and give us a thumbs up if you like our work. As you might have guessed, the BMW X4 shares the platform with the X3, but comes with a wider track and a lower ride height for that decidedly sportier stance. Now, the SUV coupes are increasingly becoming the norm, but it has never been easy for the designers to combine the traditional SUV look with the tapering roofline of a coupe. The good folks at BMW, however, have done a good job with not only making the X4 look stylish enough, but with also giving it a distinct identity that helps you easily distinguish it from the bigger and the pricier X6. The front end gets the typical BMW treatment, with a bold, upright kidney grille, sleek headlamps, and a bumper that would perhaps not look out of place on a sports car. The side profile is equally impressive and flaunts a distinct coupe look without really making the SUV look any softer. However, things get a bit fussy due to these side skirts, which really look like an aftermarket edition. The rear is where things seem to take a strange turn. No, don't get me wrong here, for the BMW X4 doesn't have an ungainly posterior, but the design of the rear end is definitely not in sync with the rest of the car. In fact, it has even got a slightly un-BMW-ish touch to it. For example, these tail lamps are not in sync with what we have seen on other BMW models, and the designers have seemed to try it a bit too hard to infuse some excitement into this car's rear end. Whether you like it or not, well, that's purely subjective and entirely your call.
While the BMW X4 looks distinct on the outside, the interior is a lot more conventional, with well laid out controls and a design that is similar to what we have seen on other BMWs. The highlight of the dashboard is this 10.25 inch touchscreen infotainment unit that supports Apple CarPlay, Android Auto and satellite navigation. What's even better is that the readouts are crisp and clear even under direct sunlight, and even the first time users will never complain of any sort of complications while using this infotainment unit. But then, that is how the latest versions of the iDrive have been. Our favorite bit, of course, are the gesture controls for the brilliant Harman Kardon audio unit. Other features that this car offers include HUD, a wireless phone charging pod, multi-zone climate control, and a panoramic electric sunroof. Now, one thing that I've always liked about all BMWs is just how supportive their seats are. The same is the case with the BMW X4, which offers really nice front seats that hold you in your position even when you're driving hard through a corner. The interior space, however, is kind of a mixed bag. The X4 is based on a wider version of the X3's platform, which means squeezing three in the rear is a pretty easy job if you can ignore the transmission tunnel that eats into the leg space for the middle passenger. But it's a steeply raking roofline that might cause inconvenience to the really tall passengers. In spite of the coupe-like rear, the BMW X4 offers a boot space of 525 liters, which is around 100 liters less than what you get on the X3, but is still enough to carry a lot of luggage. What's more, folding the rear seats can liberate more than 1400 liters of luggage carrying capacity. On the go, the first thing you notice is how nice this sporty steering wheel feels to hold, which is owing to its thick rim and a not so large diameter. The X4 that we've been driving around since the last few days is powered by a 2-liter twin-power petrol engine that outputs a maximum power of 252 bhp and a peak torque of 350 Nm. Transmission is handled by an 8-speed dual-clutch automatic unit that can be operated even through these pedal shifters. Of course, the best thing about the BMW X4 is just how car-like it feels to drive. There are 4 driving modes on offer: Eco, Eco Plus, Comfort and Sport. Mostly, we've been driving around in the comfort mode, but even with these settings, the ride quality is never as supple as what you would expect from a car in this price range. But it's the handling that will totally blow your mind. The steering is highly responsive and offers enough feedback to let you know what the front wheels have been up to. The body roll? Well, what body roll? I frequently found myself shifting to the sport mode for some quick red light getaways. And the one thing that always strikes me is that there's an urgency in the way the revs build up the moment you press the sport button. What's more, except for the healthy sound note, the occupants remain entirely insulated from the outside world. Overall, the BMW X4 should be an interesting proposition
for everyone who's looking for the practicality of an SUV and the driving dynamics of a sporty sedan. What's more, it's loaded to its gills with comfort and convenience enhancing features, and its design is sure to grab a lot of eyeballs. So, that's the BMW X4 xDrive 30i for you, and you can get your hands on one at an X showroom price of roughly Rs. 64 lakhs.